Dear students, in our previous class, we discussed recent trends in marketing. The important recent trends in marketing are e-business, telemarketing, m-business, green marketing, retail marketing, relationship marketing, customer relationship management, and social networked marketing. Now, I am going to discuss meaning of green marketing. Green marketing is also known as environmental and sustainable marketing. This involves the activities to generate as well as facilitate any exchange in order to satisfy human needs by keeping environmental safe and distributing products that will not harm the environment. So green marketing means, green marketing is also known as environmental and sustainable marketing, and it involves the activities to generate as well as facilitate any exchange in order to satisfy human needs by keeping environmental safe. Next, characteristics of green marketing. First one, products are naturally grown. Second one, products are recyclable, reusable, and biodegradable. Third point, products contain natural ingredients without preservatives. Fourth one, product packaging is eco-friendly. Fifth one, products are made in a way that they don't damage or pollute the environment. Green marketing is also known as environmental marketing, and it involves the activities to generate as well as facilitate any exchange in order to satisfy human needs by keeping environmental safe. Next, we have to study what are the importance, needs, and benefits of green marketing. First one, there is growing interest among the consumers all over the world regarding protection of environment. There is growing interest among the consumers all over the world regarding protection of environment. This is the first point. Next one, our quality of life is increasingly impacted. Third point, to fulfill the obligations of social responsibility towards society. Fourth one, to complete and follow with the government policies and procedure. Fifth one, it helps in reducing cost on account of recycling. These are the importance of green marketing. Next one, challenges and problems of green marketing. The important problems facing green marketing are, first one, firms may use green marketing to mislead the customer by means of giving false information. Next one, educating the customer about use and need of green products is difficult. Third one, established companies fear their base of mainstream consumers by appealing to the green consumers. Fourth one, it involves huge capital investment. These are the important problems facing green marketing. Next one, green companies. Green companies are General Electric, McDonald's, Walmart, Dell, Honda, etc. Next one, important trends in marketing include retail marketing. This means, according to Philip Kotler, retailing include all the activities involved in selling goods or services to the final consumers or personal or non-business use. Retail marketing includes all the activities involved in selling of goods or services to final consumers. The important features of retail marketing are sale to ultimate customer, convenient form, convenient place, organized sale and chain of distribution, and last one, creation of utility. These are the important features of retail marketing. Next, we have to study what are the important functions and role of retailing. First one, delivery of the good to the end consumer. Delivery of the good to the end consumer. Next one, selling. Next one, financing. Fourth one, supplying of market information. Fifth one, grading and packing of goods. Sixth one, warehousing and storing. These are the important functions and role of retailing. Next one, type of retailer. There are mainly six types of retailer. First one, general merchandise. Second one, specialty store. Third one, shopping mall. Fourth one, factory outlet. Fifth one, convenience retailer. Sixth one, warehouse retailer. General merchandise retailer again classified into supermarket, discount rate, and departmental store. Supermarket means generally this type of retailer concentrates in supplying a range of food and beverage products. Supermarkets have significant buying power and therefore often retain goods at low prices. Next one, discount retailer. Discount retailer means this type of retailer offers a variety of discounted. They offer low prices than the typical market price. Next one, departmental store. Departmental store means this type of retailer is often the most complex, offering wide range of products and can appear as a collection of smaller retail store managed by one company. Next, we have to study relationship marketing. Relationship marketing includes a set of activities and strategies aimed at developing customer loyalty, interaction, managing trust, and long-term engagement with all the stakeholders of the business. This is relationship marketing. Stakeholders include customer, supplier, government, and distributors. Next, need, benefit, and importance of relationship marketing. First one, build trust and loyalty. Build trust and loyalty. Next one, to regain lost of customer. Next one, builds reputation and brand's value. Fourth point, create business opportunities. Fifth one, a tool to gain competitive edge. These are the important benefit or importance of relationship marketing. Next one, customer relationship management. Customer relationship management. This means a management philosophy according to which a company's goals can be best achieved through identification and satisfaction of the customers' stated and unstated needs and wants. The important needs and objectives of customer relationship management are to facilitate marketing and sales process. Next one, to provide better customer services. Next one, to attract new customer and increase revenue. Fourth one, to cross-sell products more effectively. Fifth one, lowering operation cost by using CRM technology. Customer relationship management means it is a management philosophy according to which a company's goal can be best achieved through identification and satisfaction of the customer's started and unstated needs at once. Next, importance or benefits of customer relationship management. First one, customer relationship management strategies helps in winning customer loyalty and confidence. Second one, it aids in providing personalized product services to customers. Third one, acquiring better knowledge of customer and their buying habits. Fourth point, profiling of individual customer is possible and this helps in segmentation. Fifth one, can used an effective tool against global competition. Sixth one, developing better communication channels. These are the important benefits of CRM. CRM is customer relationship management. Next, we have to study scope and contents of CRM. First one, companies adopting and initiating CRM. First one, companies adopting and initiating CRM. Second point, customer supplies and other marketing channel partners of those companies. Customer supplies and other marketing channel partners of those companies. Third one, vendors CRM software. Vendor CRM software. Fourth one, CRM application services provides or software services provides. Fifth one, management consultation. These are the important scope of CRM. Now I'm concluding my topics. The recent trends in marketing are mainly 8 types. They are e-business, telemarketing, m-business, green marketing, retail marketing, relationship marketing, and customer relationship management. So e-business means it is an electronic business commonly referred to as a e-business, may be defined as the administration of conducting business through internet. Next, telemarketing means it is a method of direct marketing in which a salesperson solicits prospective customer to buy products or services either over a phone or through a subsequent face-to-face. Next, M business or mobile marketing means it is a process of buying and selling of goods and services through wireless technology, like mobile phones, wireless application protocol, etc. Next, green marketing. Green marketing is also known as environmental and sustainable marketing. This also involves the activity to generate as well as facilitate any exchange in order to satisfy human needs by keeping environmental safe. Next one, retail marketing. Retail marketing is the sale of goods and services to the ultimate consumer for personal, family, or household use. Next one, relationship marketing. Relationship marketing includes a set of activities and strategies aimed at developing customer loyalty, interaction, managing trust, and long-term engagement with all the stakeholders of business. The last one, customer relationship management. Customer relationship management means a management philosophy according to which a company's goal can be best achieved through identification and satisfaction of the customer's stated and unstated needs and wants. These are the important trends in marketing. Thank you.